Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to show you how to use Excel Solver to calculate an optimum mix of products in order to maximize your profit.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
Here I have an Excel spreadsheet that I would like to use in my optimization process. So over here in cells B through D, I have the profit for each one of my products. And down here in row 4, I have the cost per each unit. And down here in row 5, I have my labor hours for each of these. So what I would like to do is figure out how much of each product I should make in order to meet some of my constraints and maximize my profit. In this case, I have two constraints. I want to spend less than or equal to $100,000, and I want to use less than or equal to 1,200 hours worth of labor. So how do I go about doing this? Well, the first thing you want to do is make sure what is known as Excel Solver is installed on your computer. So if I go up here and I type add-ins, I am returned with options colon add-ins. So click on that. And down here, I can see manage Excel add-ins. So I'm just going to click this button that says go. And right here, I can see that I have several add-ins that are available for Excel. So I'm going to check the one that says Solver add-in and click OK. So now if I go to the data tab, I can see over here in the analyze group that Solver has been added. And we're going to come back and use this in a minute.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
Before we use Solver, we need to put a couple different functions inside of our spreadsheet. And the first one we need to do is how much money are we going to spend? And the formula for this is going to be our cost per unit times the number of units that we make. So we can actually use what's known as the sum product function to get this total. So I'm just going to type equals sum product with a left parenthesis. And my first array, I'm going to select my cost per unit right here in B to D4. And then I'm going to type a comma, and then I'm going to be multiplying this by what I find in row 7, where I have my number of units. So I'm going to close my parenthesis and hit enter. And right now it's set to 0 because I haven't put anything in my optimum units yet. And so that takes care of my costs, but I also want to factor in my labor hours. So I'm going to use the same sum product formula here, equals sum product with a left parenthesis. And in this case, my first array is my number of labor hours. And then I'm going to type a comma. And my second array will be my number of units. Then I'm going to close my parenthesis and hit enter. And then finally, over here in profit, I'm going to use one more sum product. And that's going to be equals sum product with left parenthesis. And this time I'm going to multiply my profit per unit up here in row 2, type a comma, and multiply that by my units over here in 7. Close my parenthesis and hit enter. So now that I have those formulas in, I'm going to go up here and use Excel Solver. So if I click this button, I can see that I'm being prompted for several different things. So let's go through this window step by step. The first thing Solver is asking for is, what objective do I wish to set here? And the objective is really just to maximize my profit. So where is my profit located? So I'm just going to click this up arrow and select this cell right here where my profit is. And remember, if you look at the sum product right here, my profit is a formula. And then I'm going to click this button again. And now I have some options here. Do I want to maximize this, minimize it, or do a value of? So I'm going to select maximize. And then how am I going to maximize this profit? Which cells am I going to change? Well, if I click this up arrow, the cells I would like to change are these three right here where my optimum units are. So I'm just going to select those and click this button again. And now this is where it gets really interesting. I'm going to have to create some constraints. So what are the constraints that I have on my system? So remember I mentioned this earlier. My first constraint is my overall cost, and my second constraint is my number of labor hours that I'm working. So how do I go about adding those in? Well, first I'm going to click the Add button, and I'm going to click this arrow, and I'm going to select my resources in cell F2, and then I'm going to click that button again. And I want those to be less than or equal to whatever value I have in H2. So I'm going to select H2 and say OK. And now let's add a second constraint for labor hours. So I'm going to click Add. And in this case, I'm going to select F3. And I already have the less than or equal to here. And my constraint is that I want that to be less than or equal to the value that I have in H3. And say OK. But let's also add a third constraint here. Let's say that in order to have it even be worth it to set up any of my production lines, that I have to make at least 50 units of a product in order for it to be worth the run. So I'm going to click Add here. And my cell references, I'm going to select each of these cells where the number of units is going to be calculated. And I want those to be greater than or equal to, and my constraint here is 50. And then I'm going to click OK. So you can now see I have three constraints, one for making at least 50 units, one for my overall costs being less than or equal to 100,000, and the final one for my labor hours being less than or equal to 1,200 hours. Next, you can select a solving method. Right here, you can see that there are three options, but we're just going to do the simplex LP one right here. And then once you've entered that data, you can click Solve and watch what happens. I can see that Solver has found a solution to the constraints that I have put in. So I now have the option to either keep those solutions or restore my original values. So let's say OK with keeping Solver solution and see what happens. So I can see down here that I have 209 of product 1, 395 of product 2, and 50 of product 3. I can see that the sum product of those is actually my $100,000, and my labor hours is actually the 1,200 hours of labor. And if I look down here, my profit is $73,817. And this is one solution of the maximum profit that I can get for creating each of these units. So hopefully that gives you a good overview of how you can use Microsoft Excel Solver when you have several constraints on a decision that you are making. If you would like to visit our blog to see more detail about using Excel Solver, I will include that link below in the description. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. As always, thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.